the first time in many decades, a truly spectacular and historic location plays host to a very special public television event. Pianist and composer Zaid returns to his homeland for one night in Jordan. A once-in-a-lifetime performance at the Roman Amphitheater in Amman, Jordan, built nearly 2,000 years ago. Zaid's One Night in Jordan is an unforgettable musical journey.
مساء الخير. شرف كبير نكون كلياتنا مع سوا مجتمعين الليلة بهالروح الحلوة لحتى نطلق رسالة محبة وسلام من الأردن محض الحضارات للعالم. لأنه عم نصور للتلفزيون العالم اسمحوا لي أحكي بالإنجليزي. Peace ultimately resides not in the hands of the governments, but in the hands of the people. For unless peace can be made real to men, women, and children, the best efforts of negotiators will come to naught. The words of His Majesty, the late King Hussein of Jordan. To whom I would like to dedicate this concert tonight. This next composition is entitled The Lion of Jordan, and I wrote it inspired by His Majesty's legacy and quest for peace in the Middle East. Ladies and gentlemen, Charlie Bisharat. This next composition we're going to play for you is very special to me because I remember when we were kids, Mom and Dad used to take us on the Friday drive, which is equivalent to the Sunday drive in the States, and we'd go past the rolling hills of West Amman to the Dead Sea to watch the sunset. And for me, family is extremely important, and I would like to dedicate this song to Mom and Dad, Mimi and Ziad Dirani.
Thank you.
The next composition I'd like to play for you tonight is entitled Santiago's Dream. And this song was inspired by a book that influenced me a great deal. It's called The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho. without giving the book away, the story talks about the dreams of the young Spanish shepherd, Santiago, and how he took the journey, believed in himself, and followed his passion. For me, I would like to dedicate this song to the youth in Jordan and around the world to dare to dream, believe in yourself, and help build a better world in the process. This is for you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Karen Briggs. And Pedro Ustas. This next song that I'm going to play for you is entitled Comes to an End, or in Arabic, Kil Sha'am Yikhlas, by my friend, the legendary Lebanese composer, Ilyas Rahbani. About a couple of years ago, I was recording in Beirut, and in the recording session, I came across an amazing, amazing singer, a young singer by the name of Jenna. I fell in love instantly with her voice, and I've been addicted to her voice ever since. And I invited my friend Jenna to be with us tonight to sing for you, Comes to an End.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the London Voices Choir. The next song that I'm going to play for you is entitled Amman.
Thank you. Charlie Charat and Karen Briggs.
This next composition that I would like to play for you tonight is entitled Haya, and I wrote it for someone that believed in my dreams and for someone that means the world to me, Her Royal Highness Princess Haya Bint Al-Hussein.
Thank you.
شكرا.
The next piece I would like to play for you tonight is entitled Kingdom of Peace, which I wrote when I was 18 years old and still living in Jordan at that time. Whenever I play this composition, a vision comes to mind, and that's what I see from the terrace of my parents' home in West Amman, where from one spot you can see the light of Jerusalem to the right and the light of Amman to the left. As I'm sure you all believe, we can never ever give up hope on peace, regardless of how challenging it might appear to be from time to time. This composition is my personal prayer for peace in the Middle East.
Ladies and gentlemen, from London, the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra. Tonight, I've also been joined by some of the finest musicians from the world, from America, from Europe, from all over, really. I would like all of our band to stand up, please. And I would like our soloists to stand up as well. Please.